Yes, we're inside the Parliamentary Archives in the Victoria Tower of the Houses of Parliament. This is Charles Barry's purpose-built archive repository for the Parliamentary Archives. It was finished in 1860, and around me you can see all the Acts of Parliament going back to 1497. They're written on parchment, in parchment scrolls, and they're just the most amazing survival inside the heart of our democracy. My favourite item is related to a book that I'm writing at the moment. I'm writing a book about the 1834 fire that burnt down the old Houses of Parliament. And my favourite record comes out of that fire. It's a letter written by Frances Rickman, who's the daughter of the Clerk assistant in the House of Commons. And the family lived on site in the old palace. And she had watched the fire come towards their home, threatening to destroy them and their family. And at 3:30 in the morning, she wrote to her sister explaining what had been going on once the fire had subsided. That's a really amazing document. It's incredible to think that it's still here on site. Yes, I think the item in the collection that sums up Parliament Week for me is the Secret Ballot Act. We have some of the most famous constitutional documents in the country in the Parliamentary Archives, including the death warrant of Charles I, the Bill of Rights, the 1832 Reform Act. But for me, the Secret Ballot Act of 1872, which allowed people to vote in secret for the very first time, I think really encapsulates what Parliament Week's all about. Up until then, people had to vote in public and declare who they were voting for, which is amazing to think that it carried on until 1872.